During the political turmoil in Europe in the early 20th century, a group of artists came together at the Café Voltaire in Zurich and began making objects and holding performances that rejected the norms of art making. They were reacting against systems based on logic, reason, and nationalism run amok that they saw as the causes of World War I. To reclaim man's true nature and restore human society, they wanted to destroy the traditional idea of art and replace it with an anti-art based on chance, irrationality, and nonsense. These artists named their endeavor Dada. With the influx of European art and artists between the two world wars, New York was emerging as the new art capital. Abstract Expressionism, the first American art movement, continued the European modernist tradition of expressing universal truth and archetypes through abstraction. However, other émigré artists joined Marcel Duchamp in New York to form a Dada group there. These artists, due to their reputations and activities, would also have great influence on a generation of younger artists looking for something beyond modernist ideas. Black Mountain College in North Carolina had gained a reputation as a creative hub and attracted many well-known intellectuals to its faculty. Three radical thinkers came together there: John Cage, Merce Cunningham, and Robert Rauschenberg. Cage wrote musical scores that included random actions, sounds made by everyday objects, and long stretches of silence. Cunningham included movements in his choreography that were jerky and repetitive. Rauschenberg was breaking down the artificial barriers between mediums in his work. They collaborated on projects that blurred the lines between disciplines. Their work would help change the landscape of art in the 1950s. As more and more artists began moving to New York, the energy for a new direction in art grew. By the late 1950s, the abstract expressionist artists' reputations were secure and a new generation needed space to grow. Rauschenberg asked Willem de Kooning, a leading abstract painter, for a drawing that he could erase. This actual and symbolic erasing of an artwork from the reigning art movement would represent the defining moment for the transition to a new phase in art that art critic Barbara Rose dubbed neo-dada. These young artists were interested in the approach of the original Dada artists. The theories of Duchamp, who was still living in New York, were influential. Artists began using industrial tools, discarded consumer goods, and mundane images from popular culture in their work. They constructed their artworks in ways that called into question traditional art-making forms. Rauschenberg called his artworks combines. Ed Kienholz created installations. The process of the work began to emerge as an important aspect. Alan Kaprow began loosely choreographing events he called happenings. Yves Klein used fire and human bodies as tools to make art. Those original Dada artists who were still living disparaged the neo-Dada work as derivative of what they had done. They accused the neo-Dadaists of turning the use of the ugly and commonplace, that for them was a means of protest, into artwork that had aesthetic and commercial value. Nevertheless, with their emphasis on bringing art closer to real life and the use of everyday objects, the neo-Dada artists would be a bridge between the abstract expressionists and another emerging movement that would become known as pop art.